Events include a $2,500 tag team tournament with the winners to meet the champions at a later date in a title match. You will see the Executioners, Bruce and Jim Gallagher, Bob Lowe, Jim Ladd, Brute Bernard, and the world's largest wrestler, 720-pound Benny McGuire, Rocky Lane, and more. Also on hand, a heavyweight championship match featuring the heavyweight champion Buddy Shane taking on the Super Rocker. NAWA Wrestling, Friday, February 11th at Drexel Community Center, Drexel.
Welcome to North American Wrestling Alliance Championship Wrestling, with your favorite wrestling stars from all over the world. Championship Wrestling will return right after these messages from some very important sponsors. You stay tuned for wrestling.
Good day, fans. I mean to tell you, wrestling fans, program in store for you today. Five big matches on our card. One of the new tag team title holders, Jay Eagle, will be going against Hard Rock Johnson in a singles match. Brute Bernard and Jim Tucker team up to go against Billy Becker and T.C. Rhodes. Dr. Cato, Brute's new manager, will also be there. Women's wrestlers today, Donna Cristantello will take on Terry Shane for the Southern Women's Championship title. Buddy Shane has won the North American Heavyweight Singles title. He'll be going against Gary Austin on today's program. And you'll get your first look at the Super Rocker as he takes on Bob Lowe. An exciting program for you wrestling fans. Let's go to Goldsboro, North Carolina at ringside and meet Mike and Charlie. Come on, Mike and Charlie.
Hi, wrestling fans. Welcome to an exciting evening of NAWA Championship Wrestling. I'm Charlie Babb, joining you at ringside from Goldsboro, North Carolina, for an exciting evening of wrestling. And action we do have in this first hour of wrestling. You'll be seeing Chief Jay Eagle. You'll be seeing Jim Tucker and Brute Bernard. Also, the mighty ladies are on the card. Donna Cristantello is here. Buddy Shane is here, and many others. And joining me here at ringside, ladies and gentlemen, my partner for this show of NAWA Championship Wrestling, wrestler Mike Shane. Mike, welcome aboard.
Johnson Air Force Base.
Well, that's absolutely right, Mike, and these matches are under the sanction of the NAWA, and what an exciting evening this is going to be. We're going to have exciting action with Chief Jay Eagles here in the first event, so wrestling fans, we'll be right back right after we take time out for this message.
NAWA Championship Wrestling is coming to Drexel, North Carolina, Friday, February the 11th at the Drexel Community Center at 8 p.m. Featured events include a $2,500 tag team tournament with the winners to meet the champions at a later date in a title match. You will see the Executioners, Bruce and Jim Gallagher, Bob Lowe, Jim Ladd, Brute Bernard, and the world's largest wrestler, 720-pound Benny McGuire, Rocky Lane, and more. Also on hand, a heavyweight championship match featuring the heavyweight champion Buddy Shane taking on the Super Rocker. NAWA Wrestling, Friday, February 11th at Drexel Community Center, Drexel.
All right, wrestling fans, we're ready to get underway here with our first event. This will be a one-fall or a 10-minute time limit. First of all, from Cherokee, North Carolina, at 218 pounds, Chief Jay Eagle. And his opponent, weighing in at 220 pounds from Boston, Massachusetts, Hard Rock Johnson. Your official NAWA referee for tonight's events, Dave Ruth. One fall, 10-minute time limit.
Well, Mike Shane, this should be a very, very interesting match here when Chief Jay Eagle from Cherokee, North Carolina, takes on Hard Rock Johnson from Boston, Massachusetts.
You know, I've seen this Jay Eagle wrestle before, and he is really a slick wrestler.
That's true, Mike. Jay Eagle's coming a long way from Cherokee, North Carolina, into the ranks of professional wrestling. And notice Burry will go behind to take down in the count of one. And Johnson moves over towards the ropes, Mike.
Yeah, this you got to watch him really close. You don't know really what to think about this Hard Rock here. He's got a Hard Rock name.
Notice him now trying to apply pressure to Jay Eagle. Eagle's very quickly moving away there. And Johnson's complaining about something. The referee says, wrestle. Into the referee's hold. Arm bar now applied by Chief Jay Eagle. And you know, Mike, this can put a lot of pressure right through that arm muscles and up into that shoulder.
I've seen him wrestle before, and he has a terrific knowledge of wrestling holds. And of course, this is what we call this sport is wrestling. And I'm glad to see there's one in there today that can really go through these holds and try to actually wear his opponent down and pin him.
Well, you notice that Chief Jay Eagle certainly uses a lot of clever moves while he's in that ring, and this arm bar has certainly got Hard Rock Johnson in a bad way. Referee Dave Ruth checking very carefully there as Eagles has pushed into the ropes. Arm drag, beautiful move there by Jay Eagles.
Now you see what I mean there. He just has all of the moves. I imagine he's got 1,000 holds.
Well, this arm bar, he's definitely concentrating on that, and this is what it's all about, Mike, in the ranks of professional wrestling. You get an arm weakened, a leg weakened, and you stay right with that. So many times I saw you do this in the ring, and this weakens your opponent and naturally gets his shoulders down for the count of three.
I really believe that when that's uncalled for, a knee in the stomach.
Something looks like a little bit of fisticuffs going on in there from Hard Rock Johnson.
I think we see a little bit better now what type of wrestler this Hard Rock Johnson is going to be.
A bill across the ring by Jay Eagles, and once again he goes right back to that arm drag and that arm bar.
You know, the NAW, North America Wrestling Alliance, is putting together some of the best wrestlers in the United States, and I think they try to choose the ones that really can wrestle.
That's true, and you notice now that Hard Rock Johnson is grimacing in pain there from this arm bar. Eagles has had that arm tied up there ever since the opening moments of this match, and I imagine all the feelings just about gone out of that arm. A knee left now by Hard Rock Johnson catching Eagles as he comes off the ropes.
He's got a shortcut. That's what some of these fellas do when they lack of the wrestling knowledge.
Watch Johnson as he goes for that big knee right to the head of Chief Jay Eagle. You know, Mike, we're going to be getting a look here on this session of NAWA Championship Wrestling at the girls. Also, we're going to be taking a look at a fellow that calls himself Super Rocker. This guy I've heard a lot about. He hails from Detroit, Michigan, and I'm real anxious to see what he's all about.
Well, this will be his first time. That hurt. Ooh. This will be.
Watch Eagles now. He throws that chop in there. Another chop by Eagles. Another chop. Got Johnson on the defensive there. Johnson is definitely on the offensive now as he comes up and catches Eagles with a big right to the midsection. Watch those boot laces, Mike Shane. Those can be very, very rugged on being able to see after you've had those dug into your eyes.
Well, I've already seen some lot of red marks on his body already. Look at that. Oh, he took him with an elbow there.
Referee goes in the count of two. Eagles keeps out.
We were talking about this new wrestler in the area here called Super Rock, Super Rocker, and from my understanding, this man is probably one of the greatest.
And we have a win, ladies and gentlemen. We have a win. Chief Jay Eagles is the winner of the match, and ladies and gentlemen, we're going to ringside to talk to Chief Jay Eagle. What an exciting match.
ladies and gentlemen, as we have our look here this on today's NAWA Championship Wrestling of Chief Jay Eagle. And if I can get Jay down here, we're going to have just a few words with him. Jay, let me first of all congratulate you on the win there over Hard Rock Johnson. That's a very tough match.
He's a tough man. He was hard.
Well, one thing for sure, I know that you're coming into the area and coming into all of the high school gyms where NAWA Championship Wrestling appears. And do you have your eyes on any particular talent in the NAWA?
Well, I got my eye on Buddy Shane. He's causing a lot of trouble. He's the man I'm looking for.
Okay, Chief Jay Eagle, thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, there you have it, Chief Jay Eagle. Certainly a competitor that you'll be seeing more from as weeks goes on right here on NAWA Championship Wrestling. And we're waiting now for the next match into the ring. And what an exciting match that is going to be when you get a look at none other than the rough and tough Brute Bernard and his tag team partner, Jim Sweetman Tucker, as they're cutting into the ring by Dr. Kato. And this should be a real exciting match. So Dr. Kato and Brute Bernard and Jim Tucker, a rugged combination, making their debut here on NAWA Championship Wrestling. And they're going to have definitely some rough and tough competition in this match. So wrestling fans, we're going to be ready for that match just in a couple of seconds here. First of all, introducing from Canada at 260 pounds, Brute Bernard. And his tag team partner from Mobile, Alabama, weighing in at 238 pounds, Jim Tucker. And they are accompanied to the ring tonight by their manager from parts unknown, Dr. Kato. Their opponents from Charlotte, North Carolina, weighing in at 218 pounds, Becker Jr. And his tag team partner, ladies and gentlemen, T.C. Rhodes. This match, one fall or a 10-minute time limit. Watch that Dr. Kato in there, wrestling fans. A most controversial man, carries a cane. We're going to be talking to him sometime during this hour of championship wrestling. Referee Dave Ruth now telling Brute Bernard to come out into the center of the ring so that he can undergo the referee's inspection, Mike. This Brute Bernard is a rough and tough individual, Mike Shane.
Well, you know, that's true. I've seen him wrestle a lot of times before, and he's really hard to understand. I think he's more animal than he is wrestling.
Well, one thing for sure, they have this new manager with them that has just broke their contracts, that Dr. Kato and Jim Tucker. This Jim Tucker is no slouch when it comes to wrestling either, Mike. He's a rough and tough individual.
But they got some pretty good opponents there tonight. These young fellas here can really go at it. And this big fella here, he's pretty good size. He's going to have a lot of on his hands to handle him.
That's exactly right, Mike. We're getting our first look tonight at TC Rhodes, and we're very interested to see just exactly his style of catch-as-catch-can wrestling. Referee Dave Ruth now checking the feet of Brute Bernard and calling for one man out. Dr. Kato now going back into the ring to discuss something with the referee.
think he's kind of in dangerous ground when he stays in there.
Double body slam. Hey, look at this. My chain ran away. The referee says ring the bell. And we have action galore. Sad hit up by Rhodes and Becky Jewell. They're challenging Dr. Cato there, Mike Shane. Somebody can get out the aspirin bottle tomorrow morning because Bill Bernard and Jim Tucker are going to have a super headache.
That's for sure. That was kind of an exciting way to start the match. They're going to do it again.
Hey, look at this. Both men slammed together there just like two freight trains. And watch this, Tucker and Bernard. One thing that you'll notice about these men, as soon as they get into trouble, they make quick exit, Mike, for that outside.
Let's not take your eyes off of Bruce Bernard or this Tucker guy. They were after the manager, and they're going to get in trouble if they don't watch out.
That's right. Referee Dave Ruth making the count. They have until the count of 20 to get back inside the ring. Is that right, Mike?
That's right. It's, if you're all the way out on the floor like they were, it's a count of 20. If it's under apron, it's a count of 10.
All right, Bruce Bernard back in now. Now having a conversation with his tag team partner, Jim Tucker. And slowly now moving out of that corner. I think one thing, if nothing else, Mike, that Bruce Bernard has gained a lot of respect for Becker Jr. and this T.C. Rhodes and up in the few opening minutes of this match.
You know, a lot of times you have to psych out your opponent and just let them know just how tough you are, or either that or you're in trouble. Nice body slam.
Right, and a leapfrog by Becker, another body slam. Side headlock now by Becker Jr. Into the ropes, body block. And it looks like that Becker might have hurt himself just a little bit on that one, Mike.
That's almost 300 pounds of man coming at you. You know, I've also heard about the Brute that he has no feelings. I mean, you can hit him, and it just doesn't seem to affect him.
Like for a TV camera to get a close-up of this face, Becker Jr. lays a big right hand right on that cauliflower ear of Bruce Bernard.
That's how he got that cauliflower, I'm sure.
I guarantee you, Mike Shane, if you don't have one and you get popped upside that ear many times like that, it won't take long to get a cauliflower. Tucker now wanting to mix it up with young Becker Jr., backing him into the corner. A big right hand by Jim Tucker. Side headlock. That was plain fist to the forehead, Mike Shane.
Well, he knows the rules. I think he's just trying to take some shortcuts here to get a win over these fellas.
This chokehold going right in there on Becker Jr. Referee Dave Ruth calls for the break and says he's not going to stand much of that. Double teaming now. This team of Bernard and Tucker are mighty, mighty vicious when they want to be, Mike Shane.
You know, you're allowed to do it. As long as you tag your partner, you have the count there before you have to break and make the change.
Definitely looked like Bruce Bernard went into his tights.
I think he's got something in his tights there.
Well, one thing for sure, him and Jim Tucker believe in win at any cost. Pull that rule book right out the window and just win whatever it takes. You notice that Bruce Bernard is wearing some sort of brace on that right arm, and he just slugged Becker right over the head with it.
Referee seemed to do the job, dude. Just rocked him right down.
There's that double teaming again, Mike.
That part of it's all right. I believe if you're going to be a team, you better have some good tags and tag right. But some of these other things are just really unnecessary in the ring.
Notice that Jim Tucker walks over very close to that corner of his and Bruce Bernard. Dr. Cato on his feet. We'd like for our TV crew here to get a shot of this Dr. Cato. He is their manager and advisor. One thing for sure, he is certainly a mysterious fellow. Becker Jr. now is in bad way. He needs to get over to make that tag to T.C. Rhodes.
You know, my Peter and I have wrestled together for a long time, and I try not to take any shortcuts in this thing. I want to wrestle. But my brother seems to be getting, you know, some of these fellows have worked on him so much that he seems to be getting more like them all the time himself, and I'm not too sure I like that.
Well, one thing for sure, Mike, each week, as we leave the folks here on NAWA Championship Wrestling, we always close with play the game to win, but play like a sport. And we believe in keeping it fair and honest and good sportsmanship. And certainly Brute Bernard and Jim Tucker are not going by that motto. They're absolutely throwing that rule book right out the window. Becker needs to make that tag now. Another big right to the forehead. A tag now by Brute Bernard to Jim Tucker. Tucker comes in. Bigfoot right to the forehead of Becker. They're certainly a vicious team, Mike Shane.
Well, they go at it with hands and feet and then some other objects in their hands, too, and that I don't like.
As he comes over in the vicinity of where Becker Jr. is, referee Dave Wolfhouse says, put him back into the ring. Becker Jr. now being put back into the ring by his partner T.C. Rhodes. A big knee down across the forehead. Becker Jr. now up to one knee. His punches just don't have much sting now, Mike.
No, but he seemed to be getting there first. I think he's going to get out of this. He's working his way out, you know. Look at that. Good, good.
Shoulder tackle now. Becker needs to make that corner. He's a little bit lost. That big head. If he can shake these cobwebs, he might be able to get over there, Mike.
I'm not too sure he knows where his corner is.
Definitely now a side headlock by Becker Jr. Finally moves over to that corner and makes the tag. A big right hand.
Now he's going.
Big brute. Big brute now on the apron of the ring, down on the floor.
Big man. I think he's mad now.
Yeah, I think the dandruff is definitely up of this T.C. Rhodes. Tag once again now to Becker Jr. Becker Jr. coming in. The referee calls for the play. A fist to the midsection by Becker Jr. Elbow. Watch this Becker Jr. as he comes in with a big elbow drop, the count of one, two, and Tucker kicks out. I thought we was going to see an upset here, Mike Shane.
Like a pin, right close to it.
Front face lock now by Jim Tucker as he throws a blow, looks like landed right to the throat of young Becker.
We're going to be in, participating in, and Buddy and myself are going to be participating in. And some of these teams that we're seeing here tonight are going to be participating in a tag team tournament. I understand there's going to be a lot of money involved, and this tag is a one-night tag team tournament coming up. I don't have all the dates, and we haven't signed any contracts yet, but I understand it's coming up pretty soon.
Well, one thing that you always see, Mike Shane, in tag team tournament, and that's tag team action galore. So I know all of the fans certainly want to make fans when NAWA Championship Wrestling comes to your area. Be sure to come out and see the finest in professional wrestling. Double knockdown there as young Becker has made it over and evidently made the tag to T.C. Rhodes. Slingshot into the ropes. And Tucker hit that mat very hard, Mike.
I can understand that. This is a big man. He's about 300 pounds, giving an elbow like that inside the elbow.
The referee now, count of one, two, three. And we have winners, wrestling fans, the team of Brute Bernard, Jim Tucker and Dr. Cato. We're going to see, wrestling fans, if we can get Brute Bernard, Dr. Cato, and Jim Tucker down here.
Rube Bernard, certainly a wild one. If we can get Dr. Cato over here on my right, Jim Tucker on this side. First of all, we'll talk to Dr. Cato. Dr. Cato, let me say, first of all, that your team of Brute Bernard and Jim Tucker is a very impressive one.
This team of Mr. Tucker and Mr. Bernard are championship material. The promoters in this area have restrained them from wrestling to their capacity. I have come into this area. I have taken their contracts. And you can mark in your little black book, Mr. Babb. If you don't have a little black book, the doctor will give you a prescription. I'm going to take these two men, and I'm going to make NAWA World Tag Team Champions out of them. You can mark my word.
Well, one thing for sure, we have that big tag team tournament coming up. Jim Tucker, how do you feel about tag teaming with one of the most brutal guys in professional wrestling, Brute Bernard?
Oh, it's a pleasure to have this man. He's just like candy. He loves to get in his hands and tie it up and get it all over him. That's the way we're going to do these guys. You seen the illegal use of elbows, choke holds that they use. All the people in this area better watch out for this team. And for you, Fatso, you address us as Mister. And don't forget it or you'll be next.
All right, wrestling fans, right there you have it from Jim Tucker, Brute Bernard, and Dr. Cato. And wrestling fans, we'll have more right after we come back after these messages. Ladies and gentlemen, this is a special event, one fall or a 10-minute time limit. First of all, in the corner to my right, weighing in at 128 pounds, ladies and gentlemen, Miss Donna Cristantello. And her opponent, weighing in at 133 pounds, Miss Terry Shane. This is a girls' Southern Championship match, one fall, 10-minute time limit. Well, one thing for sure, Mike Shane, this is going to be two thorns between two roses in this match when we see Miss Donna Cristantello taking on Miss Terry Shane.
Donna Cristantello is a longtime lady wrestler, and she is the owner of this trophy for the Ladies Southern Championship, and the championship is on the line tonight.
That's right, Mike. This match is going to be a very exciting one. A very exciting one as Miss Terry Shane goes against Miss Donna Cristantello. And Donna has been around for quite some time in professional mat wars. And it's going to be just real interesting to see how she fares against Terry Shane. There's not any relations there, are there, Mike?
No, I'm not too sure she doesn't spell her name a little different than also.
Is that right? Well, these girls, I tell you, some people say that women are the weaker sex. But after seeing this match, I'm sure there's a lot of people that will disagree with that, Mike.
Let me tell you something. Unless you've been right here to these wrestling matches in person and right here at ringside, where you can hear how hard they're really hitting, then you can't say anything. But I think all these wrestling fans that are watching better come down here and see this in person.
Well, that's exactly right. And I'm sure that you're seeing a very different view of it tonight from being outside the ring here joining me as guest host than rather being in there and mixing it up.
Well, you know, I work real hard to be a professional wrestler, and I have all my life. And but I enjoy this. This seems to be a little easier on the skin than the other.
Well, one thing for sure, you don't get as many lumps and bumps out here as you do inside that ring. But I just want to comment very briefly here while this girls' match is in there about this team of Brute Bernard, Jim Tucker, and Dr. Cato. What a wild and woolly combination they are.
Yes, Ford be participating in a tournament, a one-night tournament. I'm not too sure where it's going to be yet, but and I'm really getting a ringside view of some of the best wrestlers there is in the United States today, and that's a terrific tag team there.
That's right. A nice mare there by Donna Cristantello. Terry Shane complaining. I think Terry Shane is claiming that she had her hair pulled, Mike Shane. I would say she is one to complain because she started the rough tactics right away with Donna Cristantello.
Well, evidently Donna is talented enough to fight fire with fire. She can do the same thing right back to her, too, you know.
A step over toe hold now applied, very effective by Miss Terry Shane. And her camera picking up, looks like that Terry Shane might be holding on to the swimsuit of Donna Cristantello. Count of one, once again, referee Dave Ruth moves around very quickly. Now asking Terry Shane if she's holding on to anything besides the leg. Reversal, Donna reverses it there. Turns her over. Leg scissors are very effective leg scissors applied by Miss Donna Cristantello. Once again, putting that pressure right on up through the spinal column of Terry Shane, Donna Cristantello applying that leg scissors. Arm bar now by Donna. And this Terry Shane, she just throws that rule book right out the window too, Mike.
Well, looking at a woman's match here, you know, we see so many men wrestlers. It's to me, it's kind of exciting to see the women wrestlers because they have a lot of different types of holds and they wrestle a little different style than the men wrestlers.
That's true. It's very good to see one of our very dear friends in the world of professional wrestling, and that does many stories for all of the wrestling magazines at ringside, getting pictures of these girls, and that's Jean Gordon. Jean's been around this wrestling war games for a long, long time, Mike.
Yes, sir, and we've had a good relationship with Jean. He's a correspondent and contributing editor in some different wrestling magazines, and we're looking forward to seeing a lot about the NAWA wrestling in these magazines.
That's exactly right. We've had the pleasure of knowing Gene Gordon for some 22 years. He's one of the first people that we ever met when we got into professional wrestling. And it's good to see Gene back in action after an absence with some surgery.
Well, that's true. And he's a good man. And it's a hard job. It might not seem like getting around the ring taking pictures like that, but he's constantly in action.
Speaking of hard jobs, this referee, Dave Ruth, definitely has his work cut out for him in there with these two females. Believe you me, they can get very, very rough and tumble in there.
Well, you know, these are just two of the many, many terrific and fine women wrestlers that are going to be coming to NAWA Championship Wrestling. We have in future weeks, the world's champion, Fabulous Muda, is going to be on our television. And you know, that's something else too. A lot of people don't realize that NAWA Championship Wrestling, every week, every time you see it on television, has a championship match to its conclusion. And we look forward to seeing that, and we're not used to it.
Look at this. Dave Rue trying to get away there. Trying to get away from Terry Shane. And tells Terry Shane that she's supposed to be wrestling Donna Cristantello, not him. And a very good point, I would say, being made, because I don't think I'd want these girls on the warpath with me. You was mentioning the Fabulous Moolah, Mike. One thing we'd like to point out that she is the world's ladies heavyweight champion. And we're looking very forward and seeing her in the very near future right here on NAWA Championship Wrestling.
Well, also too, we'll be seeing the ladies world's tag team champions, the United States ladies champions. This is along with the men's United States champions and heavyweight champions and like that too. Every week we're going to see the championship wrestling.
A Bill across the ring now by Della Cristantella as hastily Terry Shane makes an exit. And she says, I just need a brief respite here to get everything calmed down before I get back in there. I think I have Donna Cristantella's dunderfoot just a little bit. Referee Dave Ruth now saying, just take it easy, let her back into the ring.
Well, Donna Cristantella didn't get to be woman's Southern champion for nothing. This lady here has a lot of class.
I like the slingshot. You know, there's not but one way to come down. That's face forward right there, Mike Shane. Donna Cristantella now going over the count of one, two, three. And we have a new champion, Mike Shane. We have a new champion. We're going to see if we can get Miss Terry Shane down to ringside here. We'll talk with her in just a moment. Some sort of controversy going on. Terry Shane coming down to ringside here. Donna Cristantella going after Terry Shane here on our hardwood floor. Terry, if I can get you over, dear, I'd like to talk with you. First of all, let me congratulate you on a fine win over Donna Cristantella.
Been after this for a long time. Woo!
Well, one thing too, Terry, that we just mentioned, that coming in the very near future here to NAWA Championship Wrestling, we're going to have the fabulous Mula, who is the Ladies World Heavyweight Champion. And I'm sure you'd be interested in having that belt around your waist.
Yeah. I think I'm the best contender in the United States for the championship belt of the world. Woo!
All right, wrestling fans. There you have it from a fantastic lady wrestler. How would you rate Donna Cristantella? Would you say she's one of the roughest girl wrestlers that you've ever met?
She's tough, but she's not tough enough. I can beat her! I'll beat them all!
Woo! Okay, there. Terry Shane says she can beat her, and she can beat them all. Wrestling fans, we're going to be back with more exciting action right after we take this timeout for commercial consideration.
NAWA Championship Wrestling is coming to Drexel, North Carolina, Friday, February the 11th at the Drexel Community Center at 8 p.m. Featured events include a $2,500 tag team tournament with the winners to meet the champions at a later date in a title match. You will see the Executioners, Bruce and Jim Gallagher, Bob Lowe, Jim Ladd, Brute Bernard, and the world's largest wrestler, 720-pound Benny McGuire, Rocky Lane, and more. Also on hand, a heavyweight championship match featuring the heavyweight champion, Buddy Shane, taking on the Super Rocker. NAWA Wrestling, Friday, February 11th at Drexel Community Center, Drexel.
Ladies and gentlemen, this will be a special event. One fall or a 10-minute time limit. First of all, at 258 pounds, the NAWA heavyweight champion, Buddy Shane. And his opponent from Monroe, North Carolina, weighing in at 217 pounds, Gary Austin. Your referee for this match is Mike Echo. Special referee that's joining us for this match is Mike Echo. And the referee signals for the bell. And we have action underway as brother Buddy goes into action against young Gary Austin from Monroe, North Carolina.
You know, my brother Buddy here he's got all the holds in his repertoire. And I hate to say this, but here recently he's been doing well, because he's doing a lot better tonight. I think he's got to be a quick one. He's got a little bit smaller opponent tonight, and a good possibility that he could handle him. without any problem. He's got all the holds, and there's just no reason why he can't handle him real well. There's a front face lock on him, and toe over and take down. You know, Charlie Babb's Buddy, my brother Buddy now, he's a lot larger than I, and we do different things as a tag team in there. We wrestle different styles entirely, but we always usually come out as winners, and I think it's because of this difference in styles.
Well, one thing for sure about Buddy, he gets rough and tumble in there, Mike. As you notice, he put that big knee right into the midsection of this Gary Austin. Another knee to the midsection.
Well, that's perfectly legal as long as you don't use the wrong part of the knee. It's like in using elbows, you just can't do certain things.
That's right, and notice young Austin here, Mike, he's beginning to fight his way out of that predicament right there, but very quickly, Buddy stops him with that big right and left. And referee Mike Echo is warning Buddy. A nice body slam, that's one thing for sure. Buddy just lifts him up like he's a sack of potatoes, Mike.
Well, it's not too often that you find a wrestler that's a little smaller, you know, and a lot easier to pick up. But sometimes the smaller ones fool you, so you have to be on your guard at all times.
One thing for sure, we're watching a lot of ring strategy here from veteran Buddy Shane, as Buddy is applying that arm bar, and he is saying now that his tights were pulled and the referee calls for the break. Referee now saying we want to have a wrestling match, not a fisticuff contest. Buddy now challenging one of our spectators on front row ringside. One thing we have to say about Buddy, he'll mix it up with most anybody.
I have never honestly seen him turn away from any kind of a fight like that. And of course, I'll have to back him up because he's my brother. But sometimes he's a little rougher than I care to be in the ring.
Sometimes he just doesn't follow the rules too well either.
That's true, and I keep trying to calm him down, but he's going a little. Sometimes he goes a little too far.
Nice block there by Gary Austin, and a big right hand catches the forehead of Buddy Shane. Buddy heads for the exit. And Buddy's out here complaining now. He's out here complaining, saying that guy used fist, saying that guy punched me right in the snoot. And I don't blame Gary Austin in the utmost. I think this young kid, Gary Austin, now has his dandruff up a little bit, Mike.
I think he's mad now. I really hate to see him get this mad, because he'll liable to do anything.
Well, I noticed right above our table here that head and nose section of young Gary Austin. Well, two brothers getting exciting here as our guest host, Mike Shane, warns Buddy about using the fist, telling him to lay off the fist. That's this. Thumb to the throat as our camera picked it up very well there. Now young Austin down on this hardwood floor of Seymour Johnson Air Force Base. Referee now making the count. Young Austin has to the count of 20 to return to the ring. Our camera picking up some very fine action here this evening. A big forearm right across the chest of Gary Austin, my buddy Shane. Our fine camera work here this evening, picking up all of the action. Suplex. I guarantee you that'll knock the starch right out of you, Mike.
If you've got a wrestler in there, you can win a match. That's the way to do it, you know, with class. That's Greco-Roman style wrestling, and he's got it in him. He resorts to these bad tactics.
Bear hug now. Bear hug. Picks him up. Picks up this young. And our crowd does not approve of that as he comes down very, very hard. Well, did he kick out or did he lift him up, Mike? I could not tell whether young Austin kicked out or whether he was lifted up. Super slam. The count of three, and we have a winner. Wrestling fans, we're going to ringside to talk to the NAWA heavyweight champion, Buddy Shane. Okay, if we can get Buddy over here, we'd certainly like to talk just a little bit to him. And Mike Shane joining us here at ringside.
I said before that he's a mighty fine wrestler, and there's just no reason why you have to do those kind of things in the ring. Now, if we're going to stay tag team champions, then we're going to have to wrestle as a team, and you're going to have to calm yourself down and do it right.
Listen, brother. First of all, we are the greatest tag team. But you see this? This mean more to me than you, anything else. Parents didn't raise no fool.
That's all I got to say.
Mike Shane telling Buddy Shane he needs to play by the rules. Let me say this, Buddy. Certainly there I saw a rough and tumble match, and you have certainly changed your wrestling style.
I haven't changed. My style always been the same. I'm tired of people beating on me, first of all. This here means money, right?
That's right.
I got another belt, United States Tag Team belt. That means money. And before I lose it, you, Mr. TV announcer, all these pig farmers around here, they ain't gonna cause me no money. I'm gonna make my money, and I'm gonna beat the people right here in the ring. Any of these pig farmers out here won't get here, let them get here. I don't care who I hurt. I'm tired of being hurt. And if you want in the ring, you want some of me, I'll be glad to take you.
I'm not a wrestler, Mr. Shane, let me point that out, but I'm sure there is a lot of wrestlers in this area that would like to meet you for this belt. We had one out here earlier, and Chief Jay Eagle.
Jerry Eagle's a has-been, just like all these pig farmers. These people sit around here on their fat carcass. They don't do nothing. All they do is complain. Well, man, I'm a man. And any man there is in the world who will take me on, here's the belt I give them. They beat me.
Let me ask you this. Would you consider... at a later date, maybe putting this belt up right here on television against Chief Jay Eagle.
What is a Chief Jay Eagle?
The fellow that said he wanted to challenge you for this belt.
He's like the rest of these people from North Carolina. They ain't nothing but pig farmers. All they knew is go out and slap their hog and go, suey, suey, suey. Well, you better get somebody in there that can beat me.
You're avoiding my question. Will you wrestle him? That's what I want to know. Will you do it?
You want to wrestle me?
No, I want to know if you'll wrestle Jerry Eagle.
Like I said, you want to wrestle me?
No, I don't want to wrestle
you. I'll give you a title shot if you want it.
I'm not a wrestler.
Well, I tell you what, man. If you ever want to take me on, you put on some tights. And until then, you keep your fat nose out of my business. And I know it's been your pleasure to introduce me to all these fine pig farmers. And I appreciate it.
All right, wrestling fans. I want to see if I can get Brother Mike back over here. Well, I never did, Mike, get a direct answer from your brother. I kept asking him. He was challenged by Chief Jay Eagle, who was in our opening match here today on television, and he kept avoiding my question. He wants to wrestle me, and I'm not a wrestler. I've never seen him do this before. Is he avoiding my question or avoiding Jerry Eagle?
No, I think he's really highly emotional, and he's really psyched up tonight after the match. I mean, I hope this is what it is. I really don't like what I see in him. And we've been together a long time, and I just don't appreciate that what he's doing, because we can't work as a team if we're doing different things.
Well, one thing for sure that I noticed there tonight that I had not noticed in Buddy Shane before, and that was him throwing that rule book right out the window and just getting in there, you know, and really mixing it up, and had absolutely no respect for his opponent. He told me out here that belt definitely meant more to him than anything else, regardless whether it was you or what it might be, that he was going in to win, And that was the name of the game, regardless of how he wanted to do it.
You saw he knows wrestling holds. He had two plays up here and all kind of terrific holds. And why he does some of this other stuff, I think he's got a mean streak in him, and I don't like it.
Sorry to break in on you, Mike and Charlie, but we need to break away for these commercial messages, and then we'll be back with the famous Super Rocker in action right here on NAWA Championship Wrestling.
Bob Stabler here very hurriedly. The winner, the Super Rocker. Well, wrestling fans, that's going to do it for this edition of NAWA Championship Wrestling. I'd certainly like to thank my co-host, none other than Mr. Mike Shane, for being with us on this edition of NAWA Championship Wrestling. Mike, one thing, your brother had some very rough comments there to make during this hour of championship wrestling.
Well, as you can see, I wasn't pleased with what I saw. A buddy can do better than that. There's just no reason or no call for him to do what he did. I mean, you saw the man out there who's got all the wrestling holds that he ever needs to wrestle.
That's right. He can certainly display wrestling skill, and he can certainly throw that rule book out the window. I've never quite saw him exactly like this before.
Well, he's getting a little more wild, or maybe it's his old age. I don't know, but because you know, we've been champion tag team champions for a long time, and I hope that he has anything seriously wrong with him.
All right. Thank you very much, Mike, and it's a pleasure to have had you with me, and we'll be looking forward to seeing you back next week. Until then, this is Charlie Babb speaking on the behalf of NAWA Championship Wrestling Promotions, saying play the game to win, but play like a sport.
NAWA Championship Wrestling is coming to Drexel, North Carolina, Friday, February the 11th at the Drexel Community Center at 8 p.m. Featured events include a $2,500 tag team tournament with the winners to meet the champions at a later date in a title match. You will see the Executioners, Bruce and Jim Gallagher, Bob Lowe, Jim Ladd, Brute Bernard, and the world's largest wrestler, 720-pound Benny McGuire, Rocky Lane, and more. Also on hand, a heavyweight championship match featuring the heavyweight champion, Buddy Shane, taking on the Super Rocker. NAWA Wrestling, Friday, February 11th at Drexel Community Center, Drexel. American Wrestling Alliance thanks you for watching NAWA Championship Wrestling.
please consult local listings for programs and NAWA matches in your area. NAWA Championship Wrestling is produced for Southern Enterprises by Al Watkins Productions.